The new topic we are discussing today, the name of the topic is regarding the chapter chemical reaction equation, which is basically for 9, 10th, 11, 12th also. And the name, the point is the factors which are affecting the rate of chemical reaction. So here the chemical reaction may be a slower, the rate of chemical reaction may be a faster. So these factors, what are the factors are there on which basis the rate of chemical reactions exactly decided? So there are 4 to 5 factors are there. And if I use directly the statement, or we are using the statement like for because of this only the kind of reaction occurs, so it can't be understood. For the reason, we have like different types of activities are there. Using these activities or experiment, you can easily find out exactly the relationship between the chemical reaction, whether it may be faster or the slower based on the given factor. Okay, so there are 5 factors are there. On behalf of that, the rate of chemical reaction, it may be decided. It may be a slower, it may be a faster. So observe, so just I'm writing here the name of the factors. First of all, nature of the reactant. Nature of the reactant. Second point, let's see one by one. Okay, first of all, I have to write all these things. First is nature of the reactant. Second is called concentration of the reactant. Concentration of the reactant. Concentration of the reactant. Third, we have size of the reactant. Third factor that we have to consider, that is size of the reactant. Fourth one, we have the temperature of the reaction. And last, we have the fifth point, it is called catalyst. We have the catalyst. Okay, so these are the 5 factors. On behalf of that, we can decide whether the reaction may be slower, reaction may be faster. Now let's see one by one. First of all, we have the first point, nature of the reactant. For this, we consider one of the activity. We have the 2 kinds of metal. We have the first is aluminium and second is called zinc. And this aluminium and zinc, we are added with, we can use these 2 metals along with a HCl. Now what happened here? Aluminium chloride has been formed along with the liberation of hydrogen gas. Aluminium chloride has been formed along with the liberation of hydrogen gas. In the same manner, when you are pouring the HCl in a test tube which contains zinc, again zinc chloride has been formed along with the liberation of hydrogen gas. If you observe, you found that reaction is not balanced. If you want to balance, you can. For example, here 3 chlorines are there. Here 2 hydrogens are there. 1 hydrogen is there. So we use 6 HCl. Now what happened here? 6 hydrogen. So 3s2 2, 6. And there are 3 chlorines are there. Use the 2. So there are 2 3s are 6 chlorine. 2 aluminium. Yes, it is balanced. It's very easy. So how to balance chemical reaction? We already have posted the video on YouTube. You can just find out that video and just learn how the chemical reactions can be balanced. In the same manner, zinc, here ZnCl2 is there. So use 2 HCl, then 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 chlorine, 2 chlorine, 1 zinc. Yes, it is balanced. So if you observe these 2 reactants, what we are discussing? Nature. So In the first reaction, there is a more liberation of hydrogen gas as compared to second one. Now question is why? Because if you observe, although aluminium and zinc, both are the metals are there, but aluminium is more reactive. Aluminium is more reactive than zinc. We have the reactivity series chart. If you observe, zinc is less reactive and aluminium having the more reactive compared to zinc. And as per the nature, if the reactant side is somewhat having the more reactivity, that is means what? Rate of reaction is maybe greater, and that's why more hydrogen gas has been liberated. And here zinc is the less reactive, that's why the rate of reaction is somewhat slower compared to the aluminium. And in this second case, we have the liberation of hydrogen gas, but it is lesser extent compared to the first one. So this was the first point, that is called nature of the reactant. It is called nature of the reactant. Okay. Now, second one, what about the concentration of the reactant? For the concentration of the reactant, we have the CaCO3. So for the CaCO3, when we added in the HCl, now what happened here? Calcium chloride has been formed, CaCl2. Am I right now? Along with formation of water, main thing, and there is a liberation of carbon dioxide gas. There is a liberation of carbon dioxide gas. Again, I am writing the same reaction, CaCO3 plus HCl, calcium chloride with formation of water and carbon dioxide gas get liberated. Now, if you have to balance, you can just put up 2 chlorine, 2 hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, 2 oxygen, 3 2 plus 1, 3 calcium, 1 calcium, 1. It is balanced. Okay, both reactions are right now balanced. Now, question is what? Suppose I told you, as per my observation, the liberation of carbon dioxide gas in the first reaction is more as compared to liberation of carbon dioxide gas in the second reactor. In the second reaction, CO2 gas liberated? Yes. In the first reaction, CO2 gas liberated? Answer is yes. But the liberation of carbon dioxide gas is more in first reaction as compared to second one. Now, question is what, why and how? If you observe, reactant side, both are equal. Product side, both, everything is same. So now, where is the difference? The answer is concentration. It means that I am using concentrated HCl in the first reaction and dilute HCl in the second reaction. That's why concentration of the reactant, because of this HCl is more concentrated. It is concentrated. That's why CO2 liberation gas is more. And here the HCl is added with the water, is added. That's why it converts it from concentrated to dilute, because of addition of water in the HCl. And it becomes dilute. And because of that, rate of reaction somewhat slower. And CO2 liberation is there, but it is in the lesser extent as compared to the first one. This is called the concentration of the reactant. I mean, it is depend upon the concentration also. If it is concentrated more, of course, more power, more utilization of the gas. Lesser concentration, lesser gas. Okay, so this is the second one. Third one, we have the size of the particle. Let's do one small activity. We have the Shahabadi tiles. Let's do one thing. There is a test tube is there. In both test tube, in Shahabadi tiles, we have to add it. But how? The first Shahabadi tiles, it is in pieces format. Pieces are there. And same weight we have, but it is in powdered format. One, it is in pieces format. These are the pieces of the Shahabadi tiles. And here also, the Shahabadi tiles is there, but it is in completely, it is in powdered format. When you add, when we pour HCl, same amount of HCl, for example, 10 ml of HCl you have to add in both of the test tube, here also and here also. Of course, what happened here? There is a liberation of carbon dioxide gas. But in the first case, liberation rate of the reaction is somewhat slower, and in the second test tube, the rate of reaction is more faster. Now, question is what? Why? Because the size of the reactant decided the rate of chemical reaction. Here, the rate of the chemical reaction is directly proportional to size of the particle. It is what the inference or the conclusion of this activity. So here, as because of the powder format, the Shahabadi tiles also, although in both the cases, Shahabadi tiles is the common thing, but because of this powder format, there is a size of the particle somewhat lesser, right? It is small in size. And because of that, although they are small in size, of course they are small in size, because that the rate of reaction is more greater. And here, these are in pieces format, that is what somewhat greater size there, because that rate of reaction is somewhat slower. So size, it also makes an important effect on the rate of the chemical reaction. Okay, so this is what the third thing in which we have to decide, what about the rate of chemical reaction. Okay, now fourth one we have regarding, so the fourth one is what? Temperature. For the temperature, we have one of the activity, and that activity regarding the decomposition reaction. So in the decomposition reaction, what activity we have? This is what the test tube. Inside the test tube, we have the calcium carbonate. Inside the test tube, we have the pieces of the calcium carbonate. Okay, this is what? CaCO3. Test tube, rubber cork is there, which containing small, like opening is there. For what purpose? To pass out this into the gas, which is evolved after hitting the CaCO3. For the heating purpose, we have the Bunsen burner, using that we heated this calcium carbonate. Okay, and finally, whatever gas get liberated, we just cover, or we can collect this gas into a vessel which containing lime water. Okay, Now what happen here? Observe decomposition reaction. What we learn in the decomposition reaction? We have that when calcium carbonate get heated, it turns into the calcium oxide plus liberation of carbon dioxide gas. And when this carbon dioxide gas, it is get evaporated from this. So this carbon dioxide gas get collected via this test tube, and finally here it passes into the lime water, and because of that the lime water turns into milky. Lime water turns into the milky. This is what the kind of chemical reaction we have in decomposition reaction. And here the temperature play a major role. Suppose we are not providing heat at the start only, by just here we have calcium carbonate, and if you are not providing heat, there is no any kind of liberation gas, and because of that lime water does not turn into the milky. But when you increase the temperature of the reaction, what happen here? When you increase the temperature of the reaction, automatically a large amount of carbon dioxide gas get liberated, and because of that this lime water turns into the milky. This is what the temperature plays an important role. As the temperature increases, rate of the reaction also increases. As there is a decrease in temperature, rate of reaction is also slower. Okay, fifth factor, that is called as the catalyst. Basically, you must know what is the meaning of the catalyst. Here, catalyst means a kind of substance whose presence only, although it is not actively participate, but their presence should be important. And presence of that substance in a chemical reaction affects their rate. It is called as the catalyst. Okay, so observe. Let us consider one of the smallest reaction like potassium chlorate, that is KClO3. So when it get heated, the potassium chloride has been formed along with the liberation of oxygen gas, along with the liberation of hydrogen gas. You can balance using the 3O2. Now question is, what if you have to increase the rate of oxygen gas which is to be liberated in a greater extent, what should we do? Now normally the answer is like that. Suppose this KClO3, suppose it is in crystalline format, so convert the size of this particle into the smaller one. If KClO3, it should be in having the smaller size particle. Maybe based on this third factor, maybe rate of reaction maybe increases, or based on the heating, that is called temperature. Suppose you increase the temperature of this reaction, there may be liberation of oxygen gas, but both of these two cases are not happen. So if you want to increase the rate of the chemical reaction, manganese dioxide MnO2 you have to used as a catalyst. When you used manganese dioxide as a catalyst, automatically rate of the chemical reaction get increases. This is what the importance of the catalyst, which is also play a very important role. Although it is not chemically involved, actually it is not involved, but the presence of the catalyst also affect the rate of chemical reaction. So these are the five factors which are affecting the rate of chemical reaction. Number one, nature. If it is more reactive, of course nature of the reactor, rate of the chemical reaction more increases. Otherwise, if it is a lesser reactive, then rate is also decreases. Concentration, concentrated versus dilute having the lower chemical rate of chemical reaction somewhat lower, but if it is concentrated, rate of chemical reaction is a greater. Size of the reactant, if the smaller size, greater the rate of chemical reaction. Greater the size of the particle, rate of chemical reaction is somewhat lower. Temperature, increase in the temperature results in increase in the rate of the chemical reaction. And last one, presence of catalyst is play very important role. Presence of catalyst also increases the rate of chemical reaction. I hope you understand the video, and please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for the further notification. Thank you.